Hello, welcome to SS Unitech. Sushil this side, and this is continuation of SIKO Sava interview questions and answers. So today we are going to discuss one more interview question, that is previous null values, and this question was asked in Accenture. So one of my friend has attended interview with the Accenture, so this question was asked over there. So let's move to next slide to understand about the question. So here, as we can see, we have an input table that would have three columns. First is sequence number, then ID, then name. In the output, we are also getting all these columns, but in the input, as we can see, for sequence 2 we are getting null. For sequence 4 and 5 again we are getting null. So if we are getting any null value, then that null value will be replaced by last not null. As we can see, in case of sequence 2 it is null, so last not null value is 10, so this null will be replaced by 10 in the output. Then for ID 4 and ID 5, so these two are null values, so last not null value is 20, so 20 will be placed instead of these two null. So how we can write the query for getting this output? So let's move to SIKO Sava Management Studio, where we will write the query for getting the output. So as I am using SQL 2017, you may have another version of SQL Server. So first of all, I would like to execute this create table statement to create the table. So command completed successfully. So table is created. Next, I just wanna insert data on this table. So we can execute this insert statement to insert the data into the table. So 6 rows affected. So data is inserted successfully. Now I just want to check the data. So select asterisk from our table, that is previous null value. Now, so as we can see, we are getting the same metadata. So before going to write the query, let's understand about the logic. So how we can replace these null values by last not null values. So go to on Excel to understand about the logic. So as we can see, first three columns are coming from input table. Then I just want to create a partition number. So this partition value will be started from 1 and will be increased 1 by 1. So here for sequence 1 it is 1. If we will get any null value after that not null value, then this partition value will not be going to increased. So it remains same. As we can see, for sequence 1 and 2 it's 1. If we will get any not null value in the next value, then this partition value will be increased by 1. As we can see, in the sequence 3 we are getting 2. For 4, 5, so these two are null, so this partition value will not be going to increased, so it remains same, that is 2. Then here we are getting the not null value, so this partition value will be increased by 3. Then this is a new ID. So what would be the concept for this new ID? So in the new ID, we just want to get the first value according to partition value. Like here we are having this value, so first value of this ID would be 10. So 10 will be used in these two rows. For 2 it is having 3 rows, so first value will be 20, so 20 will be used for 2. Then 30, so this logic will be used for getting the output. So go to our SQL Server, and now I just want to write the logic. So first I just want to get the sequence number. After that we just want to get the ID and then name. And here I just want to use the sum function, and here I need to check case when this ID is null or not. If this value is null, then 0, else 1. So this is for this sum function. So over clause can be used with the sum function after 2k12. So I am going to use the over clause, and here let me order by with sequence. Now let me call this column as value partition. Now we can execute this query. So here we are getting the partition values as we were seen in the Excel. So let me put this into a CTE, and then I just want to get the first value as I told you. So we can use this CTE, and then I just want to get the sequence number, after that ID to compare with the new ID, then the name, and now we can use the first value. So this is the first value, and we just want to get the first value from this ID, and we can use OR, and here we have to use the partition by. So partition by with this newly column, which is value partition. Now we can use the order by clause, and this order by clause will be used for this sequence. Now let me call this as new ID. So this is new ID. Now let me execute query and check the output. So here we are getting 10, then 10, then here we have null values, so 20 and 20. So null values is replaced by previous not null values. So I hope you have understand how we can write the query for getting the output. If you like this video, please subscribe our channel to get many more videos. Don't forget to press the bell icon to get the notification of our newly uploaded videos. And if you need this script, it will be available on the description of this video, so you can copy from there. Thank you so much for watching.